visit to a station of Bomber Command, Mr. Churchill wore his RAF uniform as Air Commodore. With him was Dr. Evatt, the outspoken Australian minister. The Premier also made a tour of some of the districts where munitions are being made for the coming offensive. We are now well advanced in the third year of war, and although we started so long behind Germany in this business of arming for battle, the hum of machinery is rising to a crescendo. We have grumbled at past mistakes and at production deficiencies, but the business of changing over an entire nation from peace to war production presents superhuman problems. In the light of that, we haven't done so badly. And one thing we know, there is no better workmanship than British in all the world, and soon we shall see the effect. In Leeds, the Prime Minister had a terrific welcome. Mr. Churchill spoke to the world from this platform, and he confirmed that feeling of confidence that has been growing in his later speeches. He reminded his audience that none of us is asking any favors of the enemy. That's true. Let our faint hearts bear that in mind when the enemy starts asking favors of us. Finishing the tour, Mr. Churchill inspected an armored division. He climbed into one of the Covenanters and rode in it, and he watched a roll past of the juggernauts of 1942 battle. We've been taking it from Germany while Germany was strong and we were weak. If we had wanted any quarter from Hitler, we should have been darned unlucky. Be sure that when the tide of battle turns, Hitler's gang will start crying Kamerad. But we mustn't make the mistake this time that we made in 1918. Let's make our resolve right now. This time we'll stop when we've finished.